Signal processing is built into many of the technologies that we use today, from artificial intelligence to satellites, buildings to transportation, and musical instruments to diagnostic medicine. But what is signal processing? In this video, I'm defining signal processing and summarizing why the field of signal processing is important. Signal processing is a fundamental engineering subject that appears in many applications. But to talk about signal processing, we need to start with a signal. We defined signals and how they're classified in a previous video, but in summary, we can have analog and digital signals, and these vary continuously and discretely over time, respectively. Signals carry information, but we usually need to manipulate a signal in some way in order to pull out the information or respond to it. We do this manipulation with mathematical operations, and that's signal processing, using signals in calculations. The mathematical operations can include addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, taking derivatives and integrals, making comparisons like checking for less than or greater than, and more. Generally, we start with an input signal, then we perform some set of calculations, and as a result, we get an output signal that gives us information about the input or can be used for further actions in response. This framework is used in many applications in different areas of engineering and related fields. A very short list of applications includes communication systems, where a signal carries information between a transmitter and receiver, audio mixing, such as combining sounds from different sources to produce a song, control systems, such as turning a heat source on and off to control temperature, biomedical systems, such as adjusting device settings to make a diagnosis from a medical image, artificial intelligence, such as training a large language model on a database of conversations, and finance, such as predicting the best time to buy or sell a stock. Can you think of any other applications? The signal processing concepts that we're covering in this series will give you a foundation to tackle these and many other problems. In our next video, we'll start looking at a special class of analog systems, those that are linear time invariant, or LTI. Stay tuned for more. Thanks for watching. If you liked it, let me know. This video is part of a series on signal processing. There's also a lecture notes PDF linked in the description. If you'd like to stay up to date, then consider subscribing. See you next time.